They'll happily come up and have a good look at you because they're, you know, just curious, and that's the way that they can get their food. So what I'd normally do is just, if I see a school moving in, I'll... G'day crew, my name's Luke and welcome to this part of our spearfishing tips episodes. Yeah, in this video we're not only going to go over attracting kingfish, but I'm going to sort of briefly look at a few other aspects as well, such as like how not to act, and that, and mindset, that kind of falls into the same thing. Location, approaching fish, obviously attracting fish, and then shooting them. So yeah, there's quite a few like quite seasoned spheros that I dive with, and one common sort of trait across the board is when it comes to kingies, it's almost like whatever, not frothing out too much. We don't really plan our dives around kingfish because when you start learning where kingfish are, like the pressure points, with depending on what the current's doing and stuff like that, it's almost like a given that we're going to see them. In summer, you know, between sort of November and March, with spearfishing, I think what you want to do is train yourself so that you're relaxed when fish turn up. So your brain knows to just chill out and not fill you up with adrenaline. I'd highly like recommend not yelling on the surface and screaming and being chaotic. And the more you excite yourself when you see fish moving in, let's say a big school of kingfish come through, if you're used to sort of racking yourself up, then your body's going to not hesitate to fill you up with adrenaline, and then you'll get buck fever, and you won't be able to hold your breath as long, and you'll make bad decisions. And you know, if there was a camera on you and you're seeing how you're acting towards that fish, it's not the best way to hunt. I reckon that you want to just like play everything down, be bored, be like fully chilled out. When you see the fish, it's just like seeing a bit of seaweed or something, it's just the same. And I think that just makes for way better, a way more relaxed hunting. Basically what you want to be doing is finding reef that drops away, you know, on quite a nice gradient. Big steep ledges with current coming onto that pressure point. The current is usually a pretty good sign. The kingies aren't too keen to hang around with less current. If it's quite a stagnant current and there's not a lot of water moving, quite often the kingies will sort of come up and say hi as soon as you get in the water, and then they'll slowly sort of cruise away. So that's when you've got to make your take your shot opportunities if you want to take one early on. Go out and dive the local reefs, like points, reefs, stuff like that. Swim, find, you know, big changes in depth on the topo maps, are from really shallow down to, you know, as deep as you can get, and usually along those walls and drops and stuff like that. Seeing a kingfish is just so common. Now fish like fish, and you know, obviously like boil ups and stuff like that can be quite good. Personally myself, if I know that there's an underwater reef, let's say it's 40 or 50 meters and there's a reef that comes up to 10 or 12 meters and there's boil ups all around it within 500 meters or a kilometer, if I wanted to get a kingie, I'd choose to dive on the reef. A lot of people think, oh yeah, there's going to be kingies inside those boil ups, and there will be. Kingfish are always hanging around feeding fish, but the fishy activity is just a good sign for that area. So normally what I'd do is just get in on the reef and dive the up current point and have a good look around. Sometimes kingies might be hanging out at the back side of the reef, they might be on the sides of it, they could be anywhere, but yeah, it's just a matter of getting in and having a look. So yeah, often kingfish will come up and school you. They'll school you on the surface when you get in on a spot first off. The key with that is basically coming back to mindset, like not really giving a shit, almost acting bored in the water. You know, even though they're quite curious, they still don't like predatory behavior. But if you're not acting like a predator and you're sort of making them a bit curious with what you're doing, they'll happily come up and have a good look at you because they're, you know, just curious, and that's the way that they can get their food. So what I'd normally do is just, if I see a school moving in, I'll take a dive, and if I can get down to the structure, I will just dive through the fish, gun into my body, not extended. And the real don'ts here is don't chase fish with your gun out desperately, because the fish will be running, it'll be raking on a quartering away angle. Yeah, they're still going to hang around and you still will probably get one, but it's not the best way to shoot them, because you're just bombing and chasing, and yeah, fish don't really respond very well to that. So what I normally do is just dive through them, get to the structure or get down to their level, and then have a good look around and sort of let them just come to you. Put the gun out and let them come and swim in front of the gun. They're happy to do that. And then what you can do is, like, you know, if you've taken a few kingies on them in the last few weeks or something like that, you'll have so much meat anyway that it takes the pressure off, and then you can just go and keep diving with them and learn what they do after you would have taken a shot. Because I think that's really good, because, like, how are you going to figure out what the fish is going to do next if you've already put a shaft into it? If you're in a really good area with a good bit of current and they're hanging out locally, you can have them on every drop. But if it's a little bit funny and they're just sort of coming in and the current might not be there, or that's when you want to sort of take your shot opportunity before they leave, or at least do your dive into the fish to pique their curiosity before they start to leave. Because quite often when the lead fish start to go and the fish all start moving in behind them and they're leaving, you can dive down and some of them will come back, but then they'll go, no, we don't like that. So yeah, that's quite a good little pointer is to, if you really want to take one, take advantage of the opportunity when they first show up. So in terms of attracting fish, I'll swim up onto that pressure point current area and thumping my hand on the water has worked quite well. It's like a nice sort of thump, and it ends up creating a bit of a noise under the water, like a nice boom kind of sound. It can bring sharks in too, so just bear that in mind. But yeah, if kingies are nearby, they quite often like a bit of that commotion because they have really, really good hearing, and also obviously they have the lateral line sensors. If they're quite close, they can feel vibrations in the water. So yeah, that's a bit of a technique. And then when I'm diving down and I'm actually like lying on reef and there's a few fish around, and or maybe I'm sort of, there's quite a lot of bait and stuff, quite often I'll do like a really throaty kind of grunt. And a few of those, just bear in mind not to use all your air up when you're doing that. And I find that they respond quite a lot better to that than the old strumming of the rubbers. So yeah, you can give that a jam, and yeah, it also works for other species as well. And I've even shot snapper doing it too. So yeah, and that's a whole nother thing, noise with snapper. So I might get into that on the next one. Yeah, so in terms of attracting, you flashes and stuff, yeah, you can. You are the attractant at the end of the day. You went up to the pressure point and you are a fad for kingies, because they just love hanging out with people. They don't like the predatory behavior, the being chased and the commotion, but if you're nice and happy around them and you don't really care, then that's when your shot opportunities are gonna really open up and fish are gonna be really friendly with you and follow you around. In terms of shooting the fish, horizontal is quite cool for like if you're down on their level, cool for aiming, good for getting that sort of upper like brainstem, and then the spine where it comes sort of along the top of the gill plate on that level there. What I'd say is just bear in mind if you shoot a fish, like straight on, your spear is going to be, if it gets in and around rocks and stuff like that, it's going to be bending, and if it's running straight hard, it's going to be bending backward, and that can bend your spear. If you shoot a fish that's raking away, that can often minimize the chance of bending that spear because it's not because it's already at an angle on the way out. But I will admit that shooting a fish top down is a really, really good way to land them and not damage your gear, because all the fish can do is just pivot on that spear and they have a lot of trouble shaking it. Now, I don't shoot a lot of fish top down just because I like those horizontal shots on film and I like getting down and hanging around with them. But if I saw a really nice fish coming under me and I wanted it, a top down shot would be probably the best bet of landing it if it wasn't stoned on the original shot. So yeah, just I guess just bear that in mind. And then in terms of fighting and landing and going through all of that rigmarole, I go over all of that in How to Spearfish series and in depth, and I think I'll sort of like cut it here, and if anyone wants to jump onto there from this, then we've got a heck of a lot more info on there. But basically the one rule I'd say for brand new guys is don't jump onto a reel too early, and don't drop the line, keep the fish off the reef. Also, don't pull it up too green. So let it tire, don't let it get into the reef, and don't be too eager to jump onto a reel at the start. So yeah, if you guys have any questions on that, just get at me, leave a comment and whatever. And to see more of these videos, just subscribe to the channel, and yeah, we'll put more up as we go. Thanks for watching.